Our guest is Bill Case. He's a leader in physical therapy innovation, invented the diagonal rotary patterning exercise machine, lectures internationally, and even created and produced a DVD for Senior Falls, Keep Fit and Moving, for seniors to help prevent falls. I know this is radio. I'd like to see if we could give one or two tips that your models are doing in your exercise book. And I commend you, by the way, on Stand Tall, Don't Fall.
Oh, thank you.
Because your models are not millennials, but are actual people who appear to be 50 plus.
Sure.
Right?
Yes.
I hate the male model, by the way. He has a flat stomach.
Yeah, it was. That's my brother-in-law. He looks pretty good.
Yeah, he really does. So while we're listening to the radio, and Daryl and I are sitting in our prospective chairs, what should we do to maintain our posture? One of the ones that you have is a stretch behind with a towel. And if I had a towel, I would do that one right now.
When you're sitting in a chair, and there's a different tips that you can kind of do during the day to work on posture, but in the sitting position, something as simple as you sit up straight in the chair and pull your shoulders back and then kind of tuck your chin into your throat, that's kind of not of a natural position, but what it does by pulling your head and your shoulders back for the moment aligns you up where is the upright posture. And the other tip that I show standing doing the same thing is if you're standing up against the wall, mm-hmm. with your back of your head on the wall and your shoulders back on the wall, that literally lines up your head with your shoulders, which manifests as down the rest. You know, if your head and shoulders are back, then the rest of your body is going to follow suit. The key is the head's really the primary factor to be aware of about your posture, because if your head is forward, everything else follows suit. If you get your head back, it's more natural to pull your shoulders back. So if you are sitting in the chair, you can literally, you know, take your hands and reach back behind the chair as if you were trying to touch your hands together. That makes sure that your shoulders are back. But most importantly, have the head back first. Then that way it keeps you upright. And so you can't hold that position very long, but just holding it for about 5 seconds, three or four times, but almost every hour, kind of maintains you in upright posture. At least it makes you aware of that. And then when you stand with that same posture, it's important that when you walk, I tell people to pick up their knees versus picking up their feet, because if you pick up your knees, your feet are sure to follow. But many times as people do get older, they're not standing upright. Consequently, they don't pick up their knees, and they're thinking about picking up their feet, but sometimes they can't really feel where their feet are, so consequently they trip and stumble, which is one of the main factors that leads to a fall. They usually trip on something. So if you're standing with your head and shoulders back and then picking up your knees, the odds of you tripping on something are a lot less than if you were kind of leaning forward with your head slumped and not picking up your knees.
So your head, your eyes should be looking at the horizon.
Straight ahead.
Straight ahead.
That's one of the other tips that I had is when you get into your car, if you did that same movement, if you sat up straight in the car, you know, get in the car, put your seatbelt on, and then pulled your chin back, and then pulled your shoulders back, and then adjusted the seat to you, and then adjusted your mirrors in that position, then as you're driving around during the day, if you find you can't see out your mirrors as well, it's usually because you've returned back to a slouch position. So it forces you to sit up straight again so you can obviously see front and back and on the sides while you're driving. Something to be aware of, because it's not a matter of just doing a few exercises and you're going to get it, maintain it all day. It's more of a routine, a habit, getting your body conditioned, muscle memory into having your head and shoulders back for an upright posture, which, of course, when you're upright, it shows confidence, a positive attitude, high energy. I mean, there's every positive thing goes along with standing upright. I usually tell people the worst thing that'll happen by standing up straight is you'll feel better. And so it's just a matter of being aware. Every time you pass a mirror or a reflection when you're walking, turn your head and see what your posture is doing. And then if you're not pleased with that position, then pull everything back upright. But it's that simple. to really negotiate your posture at any age. And I'm seeing more kids, millennials, with this issue because they are sitting a lot during the day.
But they have very strong thumbs, as I've said many times on the show.
Those thumbs can work without even looking at it. And I have a hard time with my fingers, but maybe I
agree.
I have to lift it up so I can see it, so that helps my posture.
I agree. Looking ahead at the horizon, looking straight ahead, is your head forward or back?
It's back.
It is back.
I mentioned the chin tuck, so it's like you're sucking your chin, pulling your chin back into your throat.
Right.
And then that pulls your head back. Then if you bring your shoulders back with it, it kind of creates an extended position, which doesn't feel natural at all. But by just holding it for a few seconds, 5 seconds, as I said in the book, then releasing off of it, maintains you more upright than if you didn't do that.
I really enjoyed the book. By the way, former President George H.W. Bush and Barbara Bush, First Lady of the U.S., are patients of Bill and have written part of the foreword. Bill, good luck with the book. Stand tall, don't fall. Take a look at this book. If you have seniors in your home, you need it. Bill, thanks again. I'm Mark Allen. When we come back, we're going to talk about cardiovascular disease and a new book called How Conventional Wisdom is Failing Us. Don't go away. Late Night Health continues. Join us at facebook.com/latenighthealth.